Jinni and Cuckoo. Hey there, and welcome back to JinnikuTV. If you're new here, we are so excited to have you join us. And if you have been following our Adobe Animate series, welcome back. So far, we have explored Classic Tween for simple movements and Motion Tween for dynamic animation. Today, we are diving into the third tweening method, Shape Tween. This one's a lot of fun, especially if you love creating cool morphing effects. So let's jump in. Shape Tween is unique because unlike Classic or Motion Tween, one doesn't have to convert an object to symbols. Instead, it's all about morphing raw vector shapes or editable text from one form into another. It works so well when turning a circle into a star or even blending one color into another. Ready to see it in action? Let's jump onto our Adobe Animate application screen. First, draw a shape. How about a circle? You don't need to convert this into a symbol because shape tweening works directly with vector shapes. Place it in the first frame of your timeline. Now right-click a little further down the timeline, say about frame 30, and insert a blank keyframe to draw a new shape or insert a keyframe if you want to just manipulate the existing shape. In this case, we will insert a blank keyframe. This is where you will create your ending shape. Next, go to your new blank keyframe and change the shape into something completely different. For example, let's turn this circle into a star. You can use the Shape tool to redraw the shape on your stage area. For this demo, we will even try to change the color. Finally, right-click between these two keyframes and select Create Shape Tween. That's it. Now hit Enter to preview your animation. The circle smoothly morphs into a star, and if you added a color change, that transitions too. Shape Tween isn't just for shapes. It works well with editable text too. Let's try something fun. I will type the word start on the first frame and the word end in the second frame, that is our frame 30. In this case, both are raw editable text objects. Once you have typed your text, insert a keyframe for the second frame, that is frame 30, and replace the word. In our case, we will change the word start to end. Now it's time to prepare your text for Shape Tween. To do that, you will need to apply the Break Apart option to your text. There are three ways you can break the text apart. First, select your text, right-click, and choose the Break Apart option from here. Second, select your text and go to Modify tab on the top here and select Break Apart. Third, simply use the keyboard shortcut. Select the text and use Ctrl B for the Windows machine or Command B for Mac user. Once your text is ready, right-click between the two keyframes and select Create Shape Tween. Now watch as the letters morph into each other. Pretty cool, right? And like Classic and Motion Tween, use the Ease In and Ease Out to further enhance your animation. Shape Tween is super powerful, but there are a few things to keep in mind. First, stick to raw shapes or editable text. If you try this with symbols, it won't work. Remember, symbols are for Classic and Motion Tween. Next, use shape hints for complex transformations. If your shapes are morphing in an unexpected way, you can use shape hints to guide the animation. Simply go to Modify, Shape, and Add Shape Hint, and place the hint on corresponding points in your shape. And finally, keep it simple. The cleaner your shape, the smoother the tweening will be. Complex or overly detailed shapes can sometimes cause odd transitions. And that's Shape Tween. It's such a fun and creative way to bring your animation to life, whether you're morphing shapes, animating text, or playing with colors. If you have already tried Classic Tween and Motion Tween, Shape Tween is a perfect next step to expand your animation skills. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to JinnikuTV for more easy to follow animation tutorial. And if you try Shape Tween, drop a comment below and share your work. We would love to see what you create. Until next time, happy animating!